Good morning and welcome back to my channel. I'm Alice May, here at the Stitch Edit, and today I'm going to be talking you through everything I've made in January and February, so basically so far this year. I'm going to be doing like makes videos every other month because some months I don't really, I might only sew two things and some months I won't sew five, so it just kind of makes it a bit more even if I do it in 2 month installments, and then also the videos don't get boring because you're not seeing the same thing over and over again. And then at the month I'm not doing it, I'll do a favourites video which will be showing you basically what I've been loving that month, and there might be some new stuff in there, there might be some old thing, old clothes that I've been loving, and some non-sewing things as well, like books and that. So let's get into it. What have I been making? So the first thing that I made this year was this Tilly and the Buttons mustard pinafore. I've made the Tilly and the Buttons pattern twice before and I love it. So this is actually a pattern that I suggest to people when they say, oh, I want to start sewing, what shall I make? And if they own a pinafore, they seem like the kind of person who might like wearing a pinafore, then I always suggest this because I think it's really motivational to make something that actually people are really surprised that you've made it when people compliment you on it, because it looks really complicated but it really isn't. There's barely any fitting to it. So the fabric was actually one that it's a bit skew-if actually. There we go, that's a bit better. So the fabric was one that I got from Coco Wawa Crafts from Anna. It wasn't from her shop or anything. She ordered it and it wasn't what she wanted or thought she wanted. And she brought it to a London Stitchers meetup that my friend was at and said, oh, anyone can take it. My friend took it for me because she thought I'd like it because she knows I like mustard. And I do. It's this gorgeous mustard gold colour. It's really soft. I don't actually know where the fabric is from, but I really like it. And then the buckles were the Village Haberdashery. They're actually silver, which I was really unsure about putting silver with mustard, because I wasn't sure if it would actually go, but I think it looks okay. I actually think it's not too bad. I did really, really seriously screw up putting in the rivets though. The back of the rivet is completely like folded in half, so I should probably at some point just buy a new one and put that one in, but it does for now. I'm also wearing my pink coat club. It has pocket spin on this. So that was actually one that I started in December and then put to one side when I wanted to make a few other things, because it was my sister's birthday, so I wanted to make her a present. And another one that I started in December and then put aside to work on other things was my Deer and Doe Magnolia dress. I actually posted this dress on Instagram the other day and I was completely blown away by your responses to it. You were so kind. It was really, really lovely to see that you liked it. So I made this in a Stuff and Still leopard print crepe, which is, I think it might now be sold out, but if it isn't, then I'll link it below. If you are looking for crepes, and there's loads around at the moment, I know Sewist Faction have loads of lovely leopard print in at the moment, so you could possibly find something similar there. But I bought this at the Knitting and Stitching Show last year, and I ended up buying 5 metres of it because it was in 2.5 metre increments. I'm really glad I did because the Magnolia does use a lot of fabric, and I chopped off, it was about half a foot for to make it. I do have a blog post on this, so I'll link it below. So I chopped off quite a lot to make it midi length, and it's still a bit too long, so I think I'm going to turn it up again and make it slightly shorter. The reason I like it is it's princess seamed, so it's a fake wrap top. It's princess seamed, so it gives that really nice shape. And the sleeves, they are actually, the ones that they do, they're like kind of bubble sleeve, you know, when they've got the elastic at the end. And I really, really hate those kind of sleeves. And the other option was a flutter sleeve, which comes to about here, which I was also like, it's it's winter, I don't want a short sleeve dress. So I hacked the sleeves to be 3/4 length, and I took in a lot of the excess fabric. I could have taken in more, and it does kind of annoy me that I didn't, but I think it looks okay anyway, so I'm going to leave it. So I made the 12 in the Magnolia dress, which fitted fine. It's slightly big on the waistband, but I actually quite like that, because it's just a bit more comfy, there's a bit more room in it. I didn't have to do any bust adjustments or anything like that, because there's enough shape in the princess seams and the hips. I usually would have to size up in the hips by about, usually by one size, but I didn't have to with this one because it's so loose and drapey. That has probably been my favourite thing I've made for a while, so I'm really, really happy about it. The next thing I made was a red sew over it Edie top. I made the sew over it Edie top for my mum for Christmas, and I loved it, and I really, really wanted, as you know, it was for her birthday, I really, really wanted to keep it, but I couldn't because it was a gift. And that was sad. But I decided that I really, really liked it and I was going to make my own version. Each month, Sew Over It do a giveaway for anyone who hashtags SOI show off. So if you make anything new, you can hashtag that, and then they choose their favourite and they give you a £20 gift voucher. Now from this gift voucher, what I really wanted was to get something to make a basic top, another Edie top, and I bought a red viscose jersey from there, so it's got really wide red and then thin white stripes. This one, I will admit, it didn't, it wasn't the kind of fabric that they suggest in their fabric requirements. They suggest using a cotton jersey, which is what I used for my very first Edie top that my mum has. This is a viscose one, and to be honest, I did not read the pattern requirements, but it works. It's a bit looser and drapier, and that's partly because I sized up, because I wanted it loose and drapey. I think it's actually a little bit too loose now, so I made the 12. It's such a simple sew. I actually had run out of the interfacing stuff that you use, the stay tape that you put around the neckline, so I was just like, nah. It doesn't matter, and I just stay stitched it. It has stretched out a little bit, but I kind of actually quite like that it's really loose and stretchy. This is a really, 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 really simple pattern. It is 4 pieces. There's 2 sleeves, front and back. It is so simple. There's not even any neck binding or anything like that. So if you are new to jersey, then I'd recommend, would really recommend it, but also choose a cotton jersey like they say in the fabric requirements, because it does look nicer in a cotton jersey. And then my last make of February was a blue floral top, which is the Butterick, oh, I've got it written down, the B6568. This is one that I got in the Great British Pattern Swap. I can't remember who gave it to me because I can't find the original message, because it's hidden so far down my messages, but whoever did, thank you. I finally got around to making it. And this fabric, I can't tell you what makeup it is. I think it might be a rayon, but I can't tell you because my little sister gave it to me. She bought it in Canada, and I love it. It's so nice. I only had a meter of it, so I did have to cut the binding on the straight as opposed to on the bias. So this top is a crossover top with a waist tie. Now my peplum is a lot shorter than the one on the model, and that is because I didn't actually realise when I was laying it out that you're supposed to cut 2 peplums, one for the front and one for the back. So yeah, that was just me being an idiot, and then I didn't have enough fabric left because I'd kind of laid it out to use up all the fabric. So I ended up having to cut that peplum in half. I'm really sorry if you can hear my washing machine. I ended up having to cut that peplum in half and then just do a mini peplum and like a really tiny hem. But I actually quite like the crop length. I think it looks quite cute. I usually wear high-waisted stuff anyway, so that's fine. I don't really mind. And that's everything that I made that I can show you in January and February. There were a couple of blogger makes that I've made for companies, but I can't show you those yet until they're up on their blogs. So I'll pop those in my next makes video. If you've made any of these and you have blog posts on any of them or anything like that, then feel free to link them down below. I'd love to have a look at what you thought of these patterns, and if you're going to make any of them, then also let me know. So I'd love it if you could subscribe or give the video a like or leave a comment. I love chatting to you guys in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.